I can see the world though in the future where I'm not missing out on those opportunities. So that's my vision for this world. My vision is to be able to have incidental learning experiences. The point is, and the key is, access for everyone here today.
So this is a deaf instructor who's in our College of Liberal Arts. He's teaching psychology. He's teaching a course here on the neurobiology of schizophrenia.
And what we'll do during the question session at the end of the talk, I would ask that you ask your questions through your device. So that what happens is in the question mode, it will actually show who is asking the question and show a transcript of your question on the screen.
We learned a lot about the classroom experience and the learning experience. In the college, the social life is very important as well. Do you have studies that show changes that technology can promote in terms of the deaf and the hearing students talking to each other or communicating with each other?
If you mean communicating through technology, it hasn't been done yet. I just wrote about it in a chapter that just went to press. One of the issues for deaf kids, even the ones who are now using spoken language and implants, is that in elementary school there aren't too many issues, except that the kids, deaf kids, who have the best hearing and speech are the ones who are most accepted by the hearing kids.